Welcome to Chapter 2, A Quick Start to Editing. This is Session 1, a chapter overview and an editing workflow. If you watch only one chapter, watch this one, because it provides an overview of the entire application. This chapter covers the entire editing process, starting with an editing workflow designed to save you time. This allows you to focus on what needs to be done right now. Each highlight movie in this chapter has an entire chapter devoted to it later in this training to provide you greater depth on each feature. A workflow keeps you organized and avoids wasting time. A hobby is something you do for the fun of it because you enjoy the process. A profession is something you do to pay the rent. Now, ideally, it's something you also enjoy doing, but the absolute number one thing with a profession is you want to get paid. With a hobby, you never really need to complete a project. It can go on for years, but with a profession, the only way to get paid is to complete a project on budget, on deadline, and to the client's satisfaction. Efficiency is everything. So as editors, all we have to sell is our time and creativity. The more efficient we are with our time, the more projects we can tackle, which means the more money we can make. Or, put it another way, wasting time costs us money. Having a good workflow allows us to concentrate on the right task at the right time. For instance, it makes no sense to correct the color of a shot when you haven't even decided if you want to use that shot in the first place. So we go and we spend time correcting the color, and it may be fun, but then when we remove that shot a few minutes later, it means all that time we spent correcting color was wasted. I hate wasting time. So I've put together a 12-step process that answers the question, what should I be doing right now? I break this workflow down into two phases, and phase one is creating your story. We start with planning what we want to do. If we don't have a plan, how do we know where we're going? Then gather the media all into one place so we know what we've got. Organize the media using events, favorites, and keywords to track our clips. Build the story into the timeline. Don't make it perfect. Just start with a rough cut. Get something there that you can look at to decide what you like and what you don't like. Build it first, then refine it. Then organize our story and trim the story. The second phase is what I call polishing the story. We add transitions, add text and effects, do audio editing, cleanup and mixing, color correction, color grading to give our images a look. Then we share or export the finished project. And when it's all done, we archive the project for future reuse. While the process of archiving generally requires separate hardware, getting the files ready to archive can be done inside Final Cut. I want to take a closer look at these 12 steps, first, because they're important, and second, because these steps are the organizational foundation of all of my training, not just this training, but everything I've ever written and everything I've ever recorded. Most of these steps have their own chapter and movies in this training, except for effects. I'm going to do an introduction to effects, but I'll cover effects more in a future title. We start with a plan. We think about the story we want to tell. What do we need to know to be able to tell it? Who's the audience? What do they expect? Who needs to see and approve the project? Who actually signs off on this? What video formats are going to be shot? What format are you going to edit? And what format do you need for the deliverable? Almost never do you edit the format you shoot, and almost never do you edit the format you're going to deliver. We're generally working with three different video formats. Do we have enough storage? What's the deadline? And what's the budget? A key concept: before you import any tapeless media, copy it from the camera or the card to your hard drive. You always want to have backups. And even though Final Cut makes it easy to import from the card or from the camera, don't do it. Copy it to your hard disk first. First, it's faster. Second, it's more reliable. And third, you've got backups. Also, Final Cut Pro 10's ability to capture from tape is very limited. You will probably need a third-party utility to do it well. Companies to look at include AJA, Blackmagic Design, and Matrox. Step 3 is to organize your media. Media is stored in libraries. Events are essentially folders to help you organize stuff. Once media is captured, use events, ratings, and keywords to categorize and sort clips so you can quickly find what you need when you need it. It is easier, faster, and better to organize media in the browser than it is in the timeline. That sounds strange, but it's true. Do your organizational work in the browser. When it comes time to build the story, we're going to preview clips in the browser, determine the shot we want to use, determine which part of the shot we want to use. This is called marking a clip or setting the in and the out. Edit the clip to the timeline, and then repeat this process over and over and over. Now, don't be too fussy at this point. The goal is to quickly create a rough cut of your story, then refine it until you run out of time. Once you've got the rough cut complete, you can analyze what works and what doesn't. Then you can fix it. Maybe the real beginning of your story is that part in the middle or the part near the end. Think Sophie's Choice or the bucket list. You can move clips to help the story flow better. Move them earlier, move them later. Delete the clips you don't need. Add clips that tell the story better. Even replace one clip with a better one. Final Cut has a ton of features that make organizing clips in the timeline faster and easier than ever. Trimming is the process of adjusting where two clips touch. And for me, trimming separates a movie edited by a professional from something just hacked together by an amateur. Trimming allows us to adjust the continuity between two shots so that they flow together so seamlessly that they don't look edited, which frankly drives me nuts because I've spent an hour trimming the perfect edit, only to have the producer not even notice how smoothly those two shots flowed together. Transitions mark the transition between editing and effects. There's three types of transitions: cuts, dissolves, and wipes. Use cuts the most, dissolve second, and wipes only when forced. Wipes are the most cool when they are rarely used. Don't spend a lot of time adding transitions until you've got the order of your shots pretty much figured out. Again, it comes down to wasting time. Yes, transitions make you giggle, but if you delete the shot, you just wasted all the time giggling over that transition. One of the things I've learned is that effects soak up every available minute between now and the deadline, plus a bit extra. Don't start adding effects until you have the story edited and complete. There's nothing worse than having great effects and no story. It's said that most effects are complete 1 hour after the deadline. I think that's true. There are three types of effects: text effects, inspector effects, and effects browser effects. Although you work with audio throughout the process, there's a time to focus on making your audio sound great. This is toward the end of the process. It's called the audio mix. Here you'll clean up bad audio, for example, to remove hum, add sound effects, add music, set the final volume, which is called levels, so that the levels never exceed 0 dB. Final Cut can create both stereo and surround audio mixes. When everything else is done, create the final look for your project by adjusting the color of the clips. This final color step, called color grading, has two parts. First is to correct for color problems, and second is to create a color grade or a look for the finished project. With Final Cut Pro 10, you can do both. Sharing creates a final version of the project that others can watch. Share both exports the media into a single finished file. Then, at your option, it will also compress it and deliver it to the destination of your choice. While my preference is to export a master file of a project, Final Cut supports a wide range of options. However, it does not natively support output to tape. If you need to lay back from Final Cut to tape, third-party hardware is required. The last step is to archive the project. Archiving is the process of collecting all the media and other assets from the project and preserving them for the long term. Final Cut makes the process of collecting assets for final archiving easy. But how you decide to physically archive the projects is up to you. My current recommendation is to use LTO tape for archiving. I am not a fan of long-term archiving using powered-off hard disks stored on a shelf. They're just not reliable enough. Now that you understand the order in which to edit a project, the other movies in this chapter show you how. We're going to start with an overview of the interface, then create a library, import media, organize media by using events, ratings, and keywords. We'll review and mark media, create a project and do an edit, organize the timeline, trim clips and add transitions, edit the audio, then share the project, and at the end, like all chapters, I'll provide keyboard shortcuts that I covered during the chapter. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks